गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन दिस लेक्चर 28 वी विल स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 3 ऑफ यूनिट 1 ऑफ 6th सेमेस्टर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड सॉलिड स्टेट डिवाइसेस, दैट इज ऑसिलेटर्स. सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज ऑसिलेटर, व्हाट इज द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सस्टेन्ड ऑसिलेशंस, एंड वी विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ ऑसिलेटर्स. सो फर्स्ट, what is oscillator? So oscillator is actually a device which we use to produce oscillations. Oscillations means waveforms, and these waveforms, they can be of sinusoidal type or non-sinusoidal type. So oscillator is a device which is used to produce sine waveforms or non-sinusoidal waveforms. Non-sinusoidal means square wave, rectangular wave, but without the application of an external input signal. The oscillations are sustained oscillations, and they continue to, the oscillator, it continues to produce oscillations even in the absence of an external input signal. So oscillator is a device which produces sinusoidal and non-sinusoidal waveforms without the application of any external input signal. And one more thing, in an oscillator, DC power supply, it is connected to the input. And what this oscillator does, this oscillator, it converts that DC power from the supply into AC power of any desired frequency. So what oscillator does, it takes DC power from the supply and then converts that DC power into the AC power of desired frequency. So now we'll discuss various categories of oscillators into which they are divided. So there are various categories into which oscillators are divided. So number one category is classification of oscillators depending upon the method of producing oscillations, that how they produce oscillations. Depending upon that method, the oscillators are divided into two categories: feedback oscillators and negative resistance oscillators. Now, as the name indicates, feedback oscillators means in these type of oscillators, a part of the output signal, it is fed back to the input signal, but that feedback portion, it is in phase with the input signal. It means the feedback is positive. So we have already studied in our previous chapter that when the feedback is negative, at that time that particular device acts as amplifier. But when the feedback is positive, that is, the feedback portion is in phase with the input of the amplifier, at that time that amplifier, it gets converted into oscillator. So first type is feedback oscillators, in which a small portion or a whole of the output voltage, it is fed back to the input, and also it is in phase with the input. And the second type is negative resistance oscillators. Negative resistance oscillator means, because in case of oscillator, there is the transistor amplifier which is used for the amplification purposes. So the transistor which is used as an amplifier, sometimes it provides negative resistance. Why? To cancel the effect of the positive resistance. Now, what is the positive resistance? Resistance is the slope of the VI characteristic curve. So when you draw the VI characteristic curve, if that VI characteristic curve of transistor has positive slope, then it will have a positive resistance type. And if any VI characteristic curve of transistor has negative slope, then it means that on increasing the voltage, current is decreasing, so then it will have negative slope, and negative slope means negative resistance. So negative resistance oscillators are those when sometimes the transistor which we are using, it provides negative resistance, means on increasing voltage current decreases to cancel the effect of the portion of positive resistance, and in this way the oscillations are set up in case of negative resistance oscillators. Now the second category of oscillators is, we can classify the oscillators depending upon the nature of waveforms generated by them, and depending upon the nature of waveforms generated by the oscillators, these are divided into two categories: sinusoidal oscillators and non-sinusoidal oscillators. Now sinusoidal oscillators, the sine function and cosine function, they are known as harmonic functions. So that is why these sinusoidal oscillators, they are sometimes also known as harmonic oscillators, and non-sinusoidal oscillators, they are also known as relaxation oscillators. Now sinusoidal oscillators are those oscillators which produce sinusoidal waveform at the output of the oscillator, and non-sinusoidal oscillators are those which don't produce sinusoidal waveform. So these oscillators, they will produce square waves or rectangular waves at their output side. So the examples of sinusoidal oscillators are tuned collector oscillator, Hartley oscillator, Colpitt oscillator, crystal oscillator, and RC, means resistor capacitor oscillators. So we will discuss all of these oscillators one by one in this chapter later on. And the example of non-sinusoidal oscillator, the oscillator which will produce square waves or rectangular waves, that is multivibrators. And we will discuss multivibrators in our unit number 2, that is about digital electronics, where we will produce square waves by using these multivibrators. Now, as we have discussed our first classification, that is feedback type and negative resistance type oscillators. So these sinusoidal and non-sinusoidal oscillators, both of these can be of negative type, negative resistance type, and feedback type oscillators. Now the third category of classification of oscillators is depending upon the frequency of generated output voltage or generated output signal. So the third classification of oscillators is based upon the frequency of the output voltage signal. So depending upon that, the oscillators, they are divided into five categories, five types. First type is AF oscillators, means audio frequency oscillators. So audio frequency oscillators are those oscillators which produce output signal of the frequency range between few hertz to 20 kilohertz. If the output signal which is produced in the oscillator, it has its frequency lying between this range, then that oscillator is known as audio frequency oscillator. Then second type is RF oscillators, means radio frequency oscillators. Now if the oscillators are producing the output signal whose frequency lies in this range from 20 kilohertz to 30 megahertz, then that oscillator is said to be radio frequency oscillator. And if the oscillator is producing the output signal with whose frequency lies in this range from 30 megahertz to 300 megahertz, then that oscillator is known as VHF, means very high frequency oscillator. And if the signal, output signal produced by the oscillator has frequency which lies between 300 megahertz to 3 gigahertz, then that oscillator is said to be a UHF, means ultra high frequency oscillator. And the last category, last type, depending upon the frequency of generated output signal, is if the output signal generated on the output side of the oscillator has frequency lies between 3 gigahertz to several gigahertz, then that type of oscillator is known as microwave oscillator. So this is all about the various types of oscillators that we have depending upon various factors. Next, we will discuss what are the essential components of an oscillator. So here I have drawn the basic block diagram of an oscillator, which consists of the parallel combination of inductor and capacitor, which is known as collectively known as tank circuit. It is one of the most important component of an oscillator, which is further connected to the amplifier, and this amplifier is basically the transistor amplifier, any BJT amplifier or FET amplifier. Then the output of this amplifier, it is fed back to this tank circuit with the help of this feedback circuit. So this is the basic block diagram of an oscillator, and it contains three essential components. Number one is tank circuit, number two is transistor amplifier, and number three is feedback circuit. And now we will discuss three of these one by one. So first is tank circuit. What is tank circuit? It produces oscillations, and it is a parallel combination of L and C. So depending upon, as we know that the frequency of the signal, it depends upon the values of L and C. So by changing the values of inductance and capacitance, we can produce the signal of any desired frequency. So this tank circuit, it is able to produce the oscillations of any desired frequency depending upon the values of inductance L and capacitance C. Then, what is this amplifier? This is basically any BJT, bipolar junction transistor amplifier, or any field effect transistor amplifier. And what this will do, when the DC power supply, or when we switch on the power supply, then it receives DC power from the supply, this amplifier. Then it converts that DC power into AC power by supplying it to the tank circuit. Then what this tank circuit does, it converts that DC power into the AC power, and then that AC power from the tank circuit, or you can say that those oscillations produced by the tank circuit, they are again applied to the input of the amplifier for further amplification. So this is the function of amplifier here. Then the third component is of oscillator is feedback circuit. So what this feedback circuit does, it provides positive feedback to the input of the amplifier. Why? To maintain the continuous oscillations of constant amplitude. To maintain the continuous oscillations, or for the sustained oscillations of constant amplitude, we use positive feedback, and that positive feedback is provided by this feedback circuit. So this is all about the essential components of an oscillator. Then next thing is the topic number 3.3 in your book of Modern Publishers. The topic is oscillatory circuit. And actually this oscillatory circuit is that how LC circuit produces oscillations. How this LC circuit, it produces oscillations, and all of you might have done this earlier in your previous classes, so do it yourself. We know that tank circuit, I will give you the brief introduction. We all know that LC circuit is, or tank circuit is, the parallel combination of inductor L and capacitor C. Now, this is the basic example of electrical oscillator. Any LC circuit, it is the basic, simplest example of electrical oscillator. So first of all, take a capacitor. Suppose you have a capacitor, and from any DC source, you have charged that capacitor, you have charged this capacitor to full extent. Means it is, this capacitor C is, it is completely charged. It means it will store energy in the form of electric field, or you can say that electrostatic energy is being stored by this capacitor when it is fully charged. After that, connect this capacitor in parallel with the inductors. And now what will happen? This capacitor, it will start discharging through the inductor. So charge on while discharging, charge on this capacitor, it will start decreasing. But when it will discharge, then I current will flow through, because of the rate of change of charge, I current will flow through this circuit, LC circuit. It means current through inductor will change. So magnetic flux will change. It means induced EMF will be produced in the inductor. So in the end, when this capacitor, it will be fully discharged, then whole of the electrostatic energy of the capacitor, it gets converted into magnetic field energy of inductor. Now after a while, what will happen? Again, the magnetic field energy of the inductor, it will start charging the capacitor, but with opposite polarity than the previous case, than the previous polarity. So in this way, this magnetic field energy, then it will be converted into electrostatic energy of the capacitor. And once again, when this capacitor, it will be fully charged, then again it will start discharging. So in this way, the oscillations are maintained by this tank circuit or LC circuit. So do it yourself. Then this LC circuit, it will be of two types. One that will produce damped oscillations and one that will produce undamped oscillations. So now next is, actually in an oscillator, there is no external input signal. So how the initial, from where this oscillator, it gets its initial input signal? Actually this initial signal required to trigger the oscillations, it is supplied by the noise voltage. And what is this noise voltage? When we switch on the power supply, then the noise voltage is produced. And that noise voltage is sufficient to trigger the oscillations in the oscillator. And then further oscillations are produced by LC circuit, transistor amplifier and feedback circuit. So it requires no external signal. Next is one of the most important topic of this chapter from the examination point of view. And the topic is, what is the feedback requirement for an oscillator? Just as we have done in case of an amplifier, that what is the feedback requirement there? That is negative feedback. And here we know that it should be a positive feedback in case of oscillator. But what is the expression? What is the mathematical expression, or what is the feedback requirement for an oscillator, which is also known as Bach-Hodgson criteria for sustained oscillations? So the feedback requirement for an oscillator, it is also known as Bach-Hodgson criteria for sustained oscillations. To maintain the oscillations in the oscillator, what is the requirement? So the Bach-Hodgson criteria, in order to maintain undamped oscillations, or you can say that for sustained oscillations at the output side of the amplifier, is that the loop gain, what is this loop gain? It is the product of the gain of the amplifier without feedback and the feedback factor beta. This A beta factor, it is known as loop gain, and its value must be unity. Unity means 1. That is, the mod of A beta, it should be equal to 1, and the feedback must be positive. It means the phase of A beta should be 2n pi. even integral multiple of pi. So this is the condition of positive feedback, or you can say that this is the Barkhausen criteria to maintain undamped or sustained oscillations at on the output of the amplifier. So this is the basic feedback requirement for an oscillator. So now we will derive that condition. So here we have the amplifier with the positive feedback, means oscillator. So this is amplifier without feedback, whose gain is A, and V naught is the output, which is fed back to the input through this feedback factor, and this Vf, it is equal to beta V naught, and then this whole of this feedback, it will act as input. There is no external input. This feedback will act as the input of this amplifier. It means this Vi, it will be equal to, that is the input of the amplifier, it is equal to the feedback voltage. So we have Vi, it is equal to Vf, and Vf is beta V naught. This implies Vi is equal to beta V naught. And suppose this as equation 1, we know that A is the gain of the amplifier without feedback, and it is equal to, it will be equal to Vo upon Vi here. So this implies the value of V naught is equal to AVi. And now put this value of V naught in this equation number 1, and you will get that Vi, it is equal to beta AVi. Now move this part to this side, and you will get Vi common 1 minus A beta, it is equal to 0. As output is non-zero, it means there will be some input here. It means this Vi, it is non-zero, because V naught is non-zero, it means Vi will be non-zero here. Here, Vi cannot be equal to 0. This implies that this 1 minus A beta, it is equal to 0. And this implies that this A beta, it is equal to 1. And you can also represent in complex form, it can be represented as cos 2n pi plus iota sin 2n pi, or you can say that A beta, it is equal to 1 plus iota into 0. So 2n pi means the phase of A beta is 2n pi. So this implies that mod of A beta, it should be equal to 1, and phase of A beta is 2n pi, where n has its values 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. And this is known as Barkhausen criteria. Barkhausen criteria for sustained oscillations. So the overall gain of the amplifier with feedback, overall gain of the amplifier with feedback will be AF, that is denoted by AF. And in case of amplifiers with negative feedback, its expression was A upon 1 plus A beta. This is the expression in case of negative feedback. But here the feedback is positive. So here I am writing the overall gain of amplifier with feedback in general case. So the expression is this. This is the general expression where this positive sign is used for positive feedback, where the positive sign is used for positive feedback, and it means what will be the expression for positive feedback. It will be AF is equal to A upon 1 minus A beta, because minus plus will be minus. So if A beta will be equal to 1, then 1 minus 1 will be 0. So A by 0 is equal to infinity. It means the gain of the amplifier with the positive feedback will be infinite. Means it will become an oscillator. And if we use negative sign here, so minus minus will be plus. So in that case, we will have AF is equal to A upon 1 plus A beta. So this negative sign is used for negative feedback, that is in case of amplifiers. So here, the amplifier with positive feedback acts as oscillator. So now, from the next lecture, we will discuss the various different types of oscillators one by one.